Parchments and glass flasks are scattered over the floor. Thick cobwebs hang from the walls, and a several inches thick layer of dust covers the ground. Sweet. Old laboratory. You find an old page of parchment here. Apparently it has the title page of a diary. You can just about make out the following text: Diary of My Inventions by Jonathan Burgund. Did I pick that up? That's not it. That's what we found in the secret tunnels. Underneath Orlando's wine storage. There's a scroll. Okay, so we didn't necessarily pick this up. We just looked at it. As you move closer to this strange object, you see that it is a huge glass globe. I kind of saw that from where I was, actually. In this glass globe, you see a beautiful panorama. A sea and large island with meadows and forests. On its south side, you can see a small cottage. One of the people with you even thinks he can see a small skeleton lying in the grass. But the thing which you find strangest of all about this scene is the fact that it is not still. It is full of movement. You can see the little waves on the sea, clouds moving through the air, and you even think you can see birds flying from tree to tree. Okay, we're looking in on somewhere, obviously. That's an actual location, which I'm guessing we can visit at some point. Same thing. I hear nothing. Talk to it? Notice that we have an option, though, to talk. What do we have? You find an old piece of parchment here. Diary page. Treasure can hold that. I'm guessing we have to use it, not look at it, yeah. This appears to be a page from the diary. Lyramion, 12-3-848. I had visitors today. The great advisor of the Pharaoh Relanuk came personally to see me, bringing an instruction from his master. The Pharaoh asked whether I could develop a new means of transport for him. In his old age, he no longer wanted to have to climb onto camels, and their bumpy, rolling motion made him feel sick. Lyramion, 18-5-848. Today, I informed the Pharaoh that my work was complete. And he can arrange to have the device collected. The great advisor was very surprised when he saw my invention. A small blue disc, which, when you put it on the floor, expands to several yards in diameter and hovers a few inches above the ground. After a short test flight, the Pharaoh's advisor was convinced by the flying disc and generously rewarded me on behalf of the Pharaoh when he left to take the flying disc to his master in the great desert to the southeast. Okay, to carry your items, I guess? Or you can fly on it, either one. He left to take the flying disc to his master in the great desert to the southeast. Alright, I should write this down, shouldn't I? As I do have this little notebook. Okay, so Pharaoh Relanuk has Jonathan Bergen's blue. Alright, blue hovering disc. I don't know if it's a means of transport or to carry your items or something like that. I'm hoping it's a means of transport. Maybe something we can use at some point. Great Desert. So, to his... the great advisor. Lyramion, 87852. I heard today that Pharaoh Relanuk died last month, and my flying disc has been placed in his tomb. Actually, I'm very glad that the flying disc is no longer in use. Last year I discovered it has certain weaknesses concerning the terrain on which it can be used. In a desert, over meadows and rivers, it can be very useful, but there are problems if it is used to travel through forests or on the sea. Okay. Adding tomb to that, blue disc. It is used to travel. Okay. So I'm guessing this is something we can obtain for ourselves. Cannot use in forests or at sea. Lyramion, 166856. I have now heard about many adventurers who tried to enter the tomb of the Pharaoh in order to find the legendary magic flying disc. I ask myself why they do not simply come to me to order a new flying disc instead of putting their life at risk. Well, I need to go talk to this guy. I wonder if he'll still be wherever we found him. Dancing Dragon, I think? Alright, so that's that. Anything else? Anything in this one? You see the same sad picture in every room, parchment scattered all over the floor, and a lot of broken glass. Well, I wonder if we'll find any surviving flasks to give to Chandra for more potions. You find an old piece of parchment here. Another diary page. Give it to Trasric. He can carry light stuff. Light stuff only for Trasric. So I'm guessing it's this one. This appears to be a page from the diary. Lyramion, 15-1-851. The Lord Chancellor of Crystal visited me today and told me that he has problems with his night guards because the sundial does not work at night, and the guards always miss the times when they are supposed to change. He needs something which can show the right time even at night. When the Lord Chancellor left, I found his signet ring. I will keep the ring safe until I meet the Lord Chancellor again. Okay, the Lord Chancellor of Crystal. That's, what's his name? Drebin. Chancellor Drebin, okay. We needed the signet ring, didn't we? To get into somewhere? I think. So, the signet ring should be here. Lyramion, 31851. I finished the work on the clock today, and I can send it to the Lord Chancellor. Lyramion, 25-2-851. I today received a letter of thanks from the Lord Chancellor of Crystal. The letter expressed his deep gratitude for the clock, and he tells me that the guards are now changed very punctually. He also said I should visit him if I am ever in Crystal. Alright. I wonder where this clock is. Lord Drebin. Clock and crystal? I'm putting a question mark here. So this takes place in the year 851. This is 848. Okay, 851, that's after that. Alright. So far I'm finding these diary instructions. Can I quit out of this? In order. Anything else here? No. Now I'm guessing this is just a chair. I'm just checking everything. Because you never know when this, where this signet ring might be. Alright. Okay, we continue on this way. You see the same picture? Yeah, same. And the same instruction. Is this the end of the area? Is this the other, only other room? I see a crumpled piece of paper, looks like, over there. You find an old piece of parchment again. Right, so 851, right? 848? Hold up. And 851, right? This one's shorter, I'm just gonna take a look at it. 15-1, 8-41, 31-5-2. Okay. And then this one. 8:50. So this takes place before this, the clock, but after the whole thing with the Pharaoh. Lyramion, 24-11-8:50. Today my old friend Melvin, the captain of the construction brigade, visited me and told me of his problem. He told me it had been instructed to drain the swamp to the southwest of Twin Lake. With his brigade, he built a huge system of drains under the swamp, but now he is afraid to enter the drains because he has already lost his way there twice, and would be ashamed if he had to be rescued again by his own people. So I told him I would think about his problem and he should come and see me again before he goes back. Okay. I'm gonna write this down. Swamp. Southwest of Twin Lake. Okay, so we got stuff. We got drains or something. Maybe a way to get through? Drains. Drains. You should come see me again before he goes back to the Growl Swamp. Growl Swamp. Okay, this is the Growl Swamp. Today I was proudly able to hand over my locator device to Melvin. He was very happy when I showed him what it can do. The locator always shows the correct position wherever one is in Lyramion. From now on, Melvin should never lose his way again. Alright. Melvin. He's dead, so we can get it. What is it called? Locator? Lyramion 2-3-853. Is something not take place on Lyramion? Because where else should he be, right? Today I received the sad news of the death of my friend Melvin. As the letter says, a construction brigade under his charge was attacked by horrid monsters in one of the new drains. The letter also said that after the attack, part of the drain collapsed. Yes, yes. How did the old dwarf saying go? Do not waken the terror sleeping in the deep. At the bottom of this page, you can also read the following reply. Water. Maybe a mouse? What do they call them? Puzzle mouse here. I tend to think of them as magic mouse. I think that's the D&D term. Magic mouth, question mark, reply. Water. Yep. So Melvin has, or had, but died. So construction brigade was attacked by hardened monsters in one of the new drains. After the attack, new drain collapsed. The captain of the construction brigade. So, if we go down into the collapsed drain, maybe we'll find their bodies and his locator. Melvin had locator, but died. Alright. Interesting. We picked up that paper, so we still see it there. Alright. Something looks like a chest there, but let me just look at these books, if possible. I can't get any closer to this stuff, so I technically can't look at it. What about the, carpet? You never know. If I sit here, I still can't get closer, right? A bunch of stuff. In this chest, you find a few torches and some old things. 12 gold. Alright, I was splitting it. I guess I clicked the wrong button. Leather boots for Satin. Can't give them to her. Another diary page. There's a signet ring. A tunnel key. Ooh. There is a key in the tunnel, in the secret tunnels, I think? Or before we get to the secret tunnels? Underneath or at the end of Orlando's wine storage, somewhere around there. Alright. Let's see who can carry stuff. Okay, Gribben has the last page. Not transfer. 8:46. Okay, so this is the first page then. Lyramion 22:8:8:46, I believe it is. This evening I saw a falling star. It seems to have fallen not far from here. 23:8:8:46. I went out this morning to seek the star. I found it. As I went to pick it up, I burnt my fingers badly. The star was red hot. Duh. How smart is this guy? Well, he's creating all these items, but he's touching meteorites. 28:8:8:46. After several days' research, I found out a few interesting things about the star. The most important thing seemed to me that the star attracts other metals, and quite some power is needed to remove them again. 38:8:46. Today I removed the metal from the star. I shall call this new metal Magnet. 29:8:46. At last I have found a use for the new metal, but I must admit that it was by chance. When I was working the metal, a sword-shaped part broke off of it. This broken piece landed on a floating block of wood. Part of my experiments with water. The curious thing is that the sword always pointed to the north. Okay, you've found a compass, then. A sword-shaped part broke off, and it landed on a floating block of wood. I then developed a device in which the sword always points in the same direction. This could be an important invention for mariners. From now on, navigators will no longer need to depend on having a clear, cloudless sky to know their direction. I believe I shall call this device a compass. This guy invented the compass after burning his fingers on a meteorite. I guess stranger things have happened. 12/11/846. Today I invited several sea captains to dinner and showed them the compass, but the evening was quite disappointing. I could not convince them of the value of the device. Unanimously they told me they still preferred to use the sun and stars rather than to trust their life to such a small thing made of wood and metal. So I put the compass in the secret chamber behind the fireplace. Perhaps I can use it again sometime. Secret chamber behind the fireplace. Got it. Quick, Batman! Back to the fireplace! Where is the fireplace? Here. That's the fireplace! How do I get there? Use our trusty crowbar. Use a spade. Use a pickaxe. Use a rope. Huh. How do I get through the fireplace? There's a separate, isn't it? There's a separate room that way, isn't there? There's a wall here. Yeah, I thought that looked funny. Let me see. Or maybe not. No. Maybe they need to use a key here. One of the keys we found? Villa key. Maybe we need to use the villa key. Or the tunnel key. Tunnel key. Maybe we need to put out the fire first. Well, I did find the signet ring. Sphere of opening? I don't want to waste that. No. Thank you. can't use, like, I was gonna try to use one of these, like, waterfall, but... I don't know how we get at that. Oh, I just pass. Okay, I just walk through it. Duh. Okay. On this table, there is a strange shape made of wire and mountain crystal. When you have removed the wire, you can reach the crystal. A strange shape made of wire and a mountain crystal. Mountain crystal. 60 grams. When you have removed the wire. I didn't remove the wire though, did I? Okay. What the hell is this thing? Who took it? Silk? A ribbon. We are really full. I wonder what this thing is. What happens if we do this? Nothing. In case we die horribly. You find no traps. No traps. No traps. No traps. Is this our stuff? This is our stuff. This is where we want to put things in. You hear the sound of a fuse sputtering. Then there is a bang, and the area is filled with blinding light. Finding no traps, though. Villa key. No. Of course, I'm not Silk. Silk is also finding no traps. Tunnel key? No. We have one slot. Well, we could always move some torches around, I guess. We could always drop some clubs or something. Before I do anything... Well, I can't even, right? Who's got a free slot? I do. So give her the villa key. We will take off the leather shoes. Now we have no slots to move around anything. I wonder if she can take all these torches. Oh, I used it, damn it. Sorry, I have so many. No one in the group has... This is really annoying. Alright, you know what? Just wait. Just put this back on. I want to give her the boots. I mean, technically I could give them to her, but then... She has no room in inventory to move stuff around. But who knows if we can even get in this thing, so... Should I keep clicking this? Do I have a percent chance, or is it like... I found a trap! Okay. I set off the trap. Is it gonna happen every time? I think so. The three of us. Yeah, the generator is already loaded, I think. You open the lock with the pass key. In this chest you find lots of scrolls and a small box. There's the compass. Potions. Healing 2, healing 3. Wow. Another diary page. Levitation. Light 2 and calm panic. I'm gonna leave some of this stuff here and come back. No one can take this stuff, so we're gonna have to... No one can take that. We're gonna have to come back here. Oh. Oh, we're blind because of... Well, at least Satine's not blind, so she can read this. Diary page, last one. I clicked the wrong thing. 8:54, is this after everything? Lyramion, 24/7/854. Today I completed what is probably my greatest achievement. I created my own world. Although my world consists just of a sea and an island, I am nevertheless delighted. Wow. 13/9/854. Today I finished work on my house in the island. It is very cozy here. Nobody can disturb me, and I have my peace and quiet. 19/11/854. My work on the world globe gave me a new idea, which I then immediately put into practice. One could consider the device I created as a miniature version of the great globe. But this is not quite right. There is no world in the crystal globe, but you can see a kind of bird's eye view of the region in which you are located. However, I noticed that the globe goes very cloudy at places where there is a strong magical force. Can I take that globe? 24/11/854. Whilst playing cards in Twin Lake today, I gambled and lost the crystal ball to the cook at the Dancing Dragon. Oh, we have the crystal ball. It's not the one in the lobby where we, the vestibule when we come in. It's the one that I think Silk has. It was not a great loss. I will simply build a new one sometime soon. Okay. I was recording. Something happened. Okay. The music left, but I'm going to finish reading this. Hopefully I'm recording correctly. 25/11/854. One bit of bad luck seldom comes alone. On my way to Twin Lake, I was today attacked by a huge green dragon. It was at least a yard and a half high. Although I was able to get away, the beast stole my bag. And the worst thing is that the bag contains the key to the exit from the world globe. I just hope that nobody accidentally travels to the island through the teleporter. I wouldn't know how to release him again. Oh, I wonder if that's that teleporter that we didn't go through. I could quickly take a look there. I have to come back here to get the rest of those scrolls anyway, so I could do it then. The bag contains the key to the exit. Alright. So that's it. I don't know why sometimes the music in this, or the sound actually, in this just dies. But I'm about done. I'm going to be headed back to, what do you call it? I'm going to be headed back to the Twin Lake to heal up, get stuff, sell stuff actually. I probably do need sling stones now. Oh no, we have a bunch, don't we? We have 23 and 30. We don't need sling stones. They're weighing us down as well. But we need to go back as well to Crystal and finally get for silk a bunch of arrows, 100 arrows. So, see you there. Actually, I'm wondering, I want to check really quick. She's so close. 15 points she can level up. 15 points. Damn. Silk can actually level up to level 6. Gribban can level to level 5. Satine, not yet. She's 1470. And Drobaneer, not yet. He needs 1350. So, Silk and Gribban can level up. If I can fight, like, get in another battle with a few things, then I can level up. And I'm going to put it, this time I'm going to put it all into spell use. Spell, whatever you call it. But that's it. And, yeah, next episode I'll see you back in our little, you know, between adventures session, which will lead up to coming back here and grabbing this stuff and taking a peek through that teleporter. First saving the game before we do so. Because apparently we have to fight a dragon to get back, so I don't think we're going to make it very far over there. But we will take a peek. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.